So in this video, we are going to discuss about the nebulization therapy. So before I explain about the nebulization procedure, okay, so I am going to talk little bit briefly about the definition, purposes, indication and side effects of nebulization therapy. So what is nebulization? Okay, so why we are giving nebulization to the patient? So nebulization is a process of dispersing liquid medication into a microscopic particles and which is delivered into the lungs, and that will be inhaled by the nebulizer, right? So that is nothing but a simple definition of nebulization. Okay, so why we are giving you nebulization? So it is basically used to liquefy the secretions which are present in the respiratory tract. Okay, to remove those secretion, we are using this nebulization. Okay, so this is the common method we use to soften and liquefy the secretion of the lungs which is present in the patient's lung. Okay, so basic function of this nebulization therapy is which dilates the bronchioles. Okay, so when we administer nebulization, okay, in the form of there are a lot of nebulization medication, that is Livolin, Duolin and aspirin. Okay, so all those medication when we administer, so it helps to dilate the bronchioles and also it helps to liquefy the secretion of the lungs, and it comes out as a expectorant, right? Next, we are going to talk about purposes. What are the purposes? So basically, we have seen the functions of nebulization therapy. What is the basic function? So, and now what are the purposes? So it relieves the respiratory insufficiency which occurs due to bronchospasm. If the patient is having bronchospasm, so that insufficiency of the respiratory tract, it relieves. Okay, next, any kind of respiratory disorders are responsible for bronchospasm, means so with the help of nebulization we can correct those kind of respiratory disorders like atelectasis, asthma, okay, all those things we can correct. Okay, we can treat those disorder with the help of nebulization therapy, right? Next, it liquefies last slides also I talked about, so about this point. So it liquefy and remove the retained thick secretions which are present in the lungs, right? Next, it reduces the inflammatory and allergic responses of the upper respiratory tract infection. If the patient is having any kind of upper respiratory tract inflammation, okay, so this nebulization helps to reduce this responses with the help of particular nebulization medication, right? Next, it also administer with oxygen. Okay, so in combination we are administering with oxygen. So what it does, it add moisture to the oxygen, obviously in order to prevent the dryness of mucous membrane. Okay, we need to moisture the oxygen delivery system. Okay, so in order to moisture the oxygen delivery system, we administer nebulization with oxygen administration, right? Next, if a particular patient is mechanically ventilated, okay, what happens? So there are a lot of air is inspired. So in order to correct those humidification deficit, so what we do, we administer or we provide nebulization therapy to the particular patient, especially in case of critically patient when they are in prolonged mechanical ventilation. So at that time what happens, so humidification deficit results. So in order to prevent that, so in order to prevent that is inspired air also, so in order to prevent that we give nebulization to the patient. Okay, next we are going to see about the indications, what in which conditions we are providing nebulization therapy to the patient. First one is bronchospasm. So when bronchioles are like there is a spasm present in the bronchioles. Okay. Next, chest tightness. Okay. Next, stridor. Next, respiratory congestion, pneumonia. So you know all those terms, like pneumonia is nothing but infection of the lungs. Next, atelectasis. Atelectasis is nothing but collapse in the lungs, asthma. And also the last one is if the person is unable to use a inhaler. Okay, so we'll see what are the types of nebulization. In that I am going to talk about this, what is inhaler and what are the different types of nebulizers are present. Okay, this is all about indication. Next, types of nebulizer. So basically we have three types of nebulizer. Okay, so one is inhaler or metered dose nebulizer. Okay, so which are commonly used for asthma patient. Okay, those who has to take inhalation for prolonged period. Okay, so in that case we are using inhaler, which is easily portable and it works with the help of spray. Okay, so that is nothing but inhaler or metered dose nebulizer. Next, jet nebulizer, which are commonly used in clinical setup. Okay, so next, third one, we have ultrasonic nebulizer. Okay, so when we want to administer hypertonic solution with the help of nebulization, okay, so it provides a large amount of mist, okay, and which disperses into the lungs. Okay, so it works with the waves. Okay, so that is what it is known as ultrasonic nebulizer. Okay, so these are the three types of nebulizer. Next, we are going to talk about side effects. So what are the side effects of nebulization therapy? So nebulization, since with the help of mist, the patient is getting the medication into the lungs. Okay, so what it does actually, it softens the mucous membrane. It prevents the breakdown of the mucous membrane. But still, dry or irritated throat can be the side effect, and it can be temporarily also, or occasional cough also can be there. Okay. Next, sneezing, stuffy or itchy nose, watery eyes. Since the nebulization medication they are inhaling, so they can have all these side effects. Next, burning or bleeding of your nose. So it is because of dryness of the mucous membrane. Okay, so if there is a breakdown in the mucous membrane, it can lead to bleeding of your nose also. Next, nausea, heartburn and stomach pain. Okay, so next, there are some more side effects, urinating more or less than usual, dizziness, drowsiness, headache, okay, unusual or unpleasant taste in your mouth. So most of the patient will complain about this unusual or unpleasant taste in the mouth. Okay, so these are the common side effects of nebulization therapy. Next, we have contraindication. So usually what happens, there will be increase in the blood pressure and cardiac irritability. Okay, dysarrhythmia can be present. Next, increase in the pulses or pulse rate. Next, unconscious patient. So when all these conditions are there, we should not administer or provide nebulization therapy. Okay, so unconscious patient, in case of unconscious patient, what happened? Inhalation may be done via mask, but the therapeutic effect may be significantly low. So unconscious patient, they cannot inhale properly. So that is what we should avoid nebulization therapy for the unconscious patient, right? So these are all about contraindications. Okay, now we are going to see the parts of nebulization machine. So you can see, so this is jet type of nebulization machine. So we have got different types of nebulization machine. Among that three types, we have jet type of nebulization machine, which is commonly used in the clinical setup. Okay, so you can see, so here handle is there, which is easily carrying handle. Okay, so this part is known as flip top, where we can easily store the nebulization mask. Okay, so here in this flip top you can see power source is present, then connecting tube. Okay, so the one end of the nebulization mask, okay, so in that connecting tube is there, so that connecting tube we are going to connect here. Okay, next we have the vents over here and sleep pad over here. With the help of this, the mist is produced. Okay, next there is a plug point, okay, electric source plug point, which we can connect to the electric source. So these are the parts of nebulization machine. Now we are going to see what are the equipments are required for nebulization therapy. So you are seeing here three trays are available. In this clean three trays, one tray contains nebulization machine and medication chart. So where the physician's order is written, okay, how much amount of nebulization medication to be given to the patient. The other tray contains normal saline to dilute the nebulization medicine and sputum cut in order to collect the expectorant if it is there for the particular patient. Next, I have got kidney tray to discard the cotton balls and gauze piece in a bowl containing cotton balls and gauze piece. Next, sterile water. The third tray contains the different sizes of nebulization mask. Okay, so for adult we are using this mask. Okay, so now I'm going to tell about what are the parts of nebulization mask. You can see this is the face mask, where mouth, it is also known as mouthpiece, okay, which we are connecting to the patient's mouth and nose, right? Next, this face mask again we can adjust with these strings. Okay, so next we have nebulization chamber, which also can be removable or opened, okay, where we are pouring the nebulization medication. Okay, nebulization medication. This is tubings. Okay, this is nebulization tubings, which has two ends. One end we can connect to the nebulization mask and the other end we can connect to the nebulization machine. So this is how we can connect the tubings. So this is used for adult. Next, we have got pediatric nebulization mask also. So this is used for children and this is used for newborn. So these are the different sizes of nebulization mask. Okay, so next we are going to talk about or demonstrate how the nebulization therapy is done, right? So first we need to wash our hands. Okay, so that will be medical hand washing, right? Medical hand washing. Next, we'll explain the procedure, the steps of the procedure to the patient. If we give nebulization therapy, what is the effect of nebulization therapy? What is the therapeutic effect we have on the patient? What are the side effects we have on the patient? So those things we are going to explain and how the procedure we will carry on. Okay, so that parts we are going to explain to the patient. Next, we'll give comfortable position to the patient, that is semi-follows position, in order to expand the lungs, okay, so that the medication will disperse in the lungs. Okay, so this is semi-follows position. Already I have given semi-follows position to the patient. Now we are going to fix the nebulization machine. So before starting the nebulization therapy, we should check the electric source whether
properly it is working or not, any short circuit is there or not, that those part we are going to check. Okay, once we check that, we are going to connect the tubings with the nebulization mask. Then we are going to connect the tubings with the nebulization machine. Right, so I have taken the clean nebulization mask. Okay, so no need to clean again. So next we are going to connect to the electric source, then we are going to connect to the patient. Before we connect to the electric source, we should pour the medicine into the nebulization chamber. Before we pour the medicine, we should cross check the medicine with the medication chart. Okay, and physician order also we should check. Once we cross check the medication chart with the rescue, then we should pour the medicine to the nebulization chamber. Once we pour, we are going to again close the nebulization chamber. We are going to connect the face mask.
Record
record. Once you finish that recording, you can wash your hand, replace the articles, right? All those things you can do. So after providing nebulization therapy to the patient, so we should instruct the patient to remain in the same position at least for 10 to 15 minutes in order to disperse the medicine properly into the lungs. Okay. After that, while they are sitting position, you should instruct the patient if they are having any irritation or any kind of side effects, like I have explained side effects, right? If any kind of side effects are present in the patient, immediately they should inform. Okay, so those instructions to be given to the patient. Okay, after that they can lie down. Okay, you can provide supine position to the patient.